Well, well, well. What is poppin', gamers and gamerettes? Welcome to the G-Boy E3. Today is a very special day, not only because you're getting an E3 of just me and the things I've been working on, but because I also turned 19 today. Yay! Alright. Now, enough about me. Let's get to the games, movies, comics, and albums. We have a lot of announcements today, and I don't know what I meant by we. I've been making all this stuff by my fucking self. Let's just get into it. First, let's begin with We Found a Planet. For those who remember the movie, it's a PowerPoint movie I've live-streamed once on YouTube, and I've decided to record the whole thing. Well, of course, my recording software is too much laggy, and I have to wait to get a better video card, which will be the date this video uploads, 25 June. And I will be not only recording the movie without lags or any issues, but I will also rewrite some phrases so the story flows better, it's a bit better. There's a lot of rewriting to be done. Not a redraw though, I will not redraw any frame from the movie because I want to keep it as authentic as it is, but I will be rewriting some phrases and I'll release on YouTube. And not only that, but I would also release the movie as this PowerPoint file on itch.io.com in a way where you can yourself enjoy the movie, where it tell you when to click and when not to click. You're getting the movie on YouTube and on itch.io. So that's really great, and it's all gonna be remade, all good, not all remade, but some stuff will be rewritten, it's gonna be re-uploaded, and I really hope you enjoy this rework, I guess we can call it, of the movie. I even have a special trailer for you, for those who never watched that movie before. Let's roll that trailer! Wasn't that just
epic?
Now, let's get to our next subject, which is still in the franchise of We Found a Planet, and that is the We Found a Planet game. You probably heard of it before. It's been here for a while on this channel. There's at least, I think, two or three videos just about it. And, well, I got more news regarding that game, and that is release dates. The game should come out either this month, which I really doubt, or next month. And the reason why, it's because the game has been made since last year, but it's all in French and I need to translate it to English. And this month was the month where I decided to translate the game to English, or was it last month? I don't remember. But I recently decided to translate the game to English so it can be available to all of you guys. How epic is that? Also, if you like to experience the game for yourself, there is a demo on itch.io available right now. And just like the movie, the game is playable in PowerPoint. And I know you might be telling me right now, G-Boy, that's impossible. It is. It is a fully functional point-and-click game, and I really invite you to play this game right now. It's really fun, and the demo has a lot of content and a lot of hidden stuff inside. That's not that hidden. I put from a very hidden Easter egg. But we'll come to this later, this very E3. So please, enjoy the teaser of the game if you haven't seen it yet.
Stone in the sea.
Well, wasn't that just epically nice? Now, let's talk about the future of We Found a Planet, because this series doesn't stop here. We have one more game and one more movie to go before I am ready. I was going to say we by accident, but I just remember I'm doing all of this by myself. Before I am ready to close this series down. Oh, and I almost forgot. We also have We Found a Planet comic coming up, but we're not ready to talk about this yet. So before we can jump into yet another trailer, let's talk about the second game a bit. The story is going to be completely different from the last game. It is another character we're following. It's a father, actually. And it's going to be a whole different planet. It's going to talk about a war that has happened and that We Found a Planet lore. And you're going to get to experience that war because you're going to be the leader of that very planet yourself. There's going to be a lot of cool stuff coming up, and that's pretty much all I can say. It started as a tiny DLC with a very, very fucked up ending. But the game slowly progressed to be something else, and it became what it is today. Release dates for this game should be either very late December this year or next year. Or it might come out to a totally different date. I'm not sure yet, but please, enjoy the trailer. Wasn't that just an epic trailer right there? Well, I hope it was. Because our next subject is about another PowerPoint game called MOVE. Now, MOVE is going to be like We Found a Planet, but just puzzles and a bit of story sprinkles in there. Pringles chips? We don't know. That's the fun of it. It's a big old mystery game. And it's a bit surreal, so yeah. You can actually play the demo of this very game and the Easter egg of We Found a Planet the game. And for those who want to unlock it, there's a tutorial on my channel. Shh, don't tell anyone. So, yeah, that's pretty much all I can say about this game. I like to keep it a mystery. So, with no further ado, let's fucking play the trailer for MOVE.
Thank you.
Well. Wasn't that just a well? All right, now I'm going to be talking about two games. One of them is called Hatchi and should hopefully come out this year. It's about a 10-year-old girl with a Tamagotchi toy, basically. Well, it's called Hatchi, but it's basically Tamagotchi. And you're basically going to go through your life. And stuff's going to happen, and that's all I'm going to say, because I refuse to spoil you anything. But the ending is just as incredible and as something as my other games. You're going to see something about my games. Is that the ending? It's fucking something. I guess I can say the same about my movies, right? Anyway, the other game is going to come out in 2020. It's called The Lab, and that's all I'm going to say about it. The Lab, it's in very early development, but it's you guys are going to fucking love it. It's a secret. It's one end of a secret, trust me. You're going to understand what's going to come out. Oh, and I almost forgot a game called Simon. It's going to be a dating simulator. You heard me right. A dating simulator from me. And that's all I'm going to say about this one, too. This one is also in extremely early development. I'm not even sure if it's going to happen. This is definitely going to come out in 2020. And yeah, it's about to be good. You're going to be a girl trying to date a guy called Simon. That's all I'm going to say. So yeah, get excited, I guess. Okie dokie. Now we're finally done talking about games. Now let's talk about mods. And let's begin with Fluo Green. Now, some of those might remember what is Fluo Green, as I made like two updates videos about it. And I've been playing, making a third one, but I kind of left the mod behind because the Holonyemi community is so fucking salty that I kind of just gave up on the mod after a while. But now I'm like, alright, stop being a fucking crybaby, G-Boy just finished the fucking mod already. Which is what I'm planning to do right now. Fluo Green for Holonyemi 1 should come out this June, hopefully. And Fluo Green for Holonyemi 2, date still unknown. But I'm working towards it, don't worry. So yeah, good news everybody. The mod is not dead, I almost said the game. And also you can find the page for Fluo Green on Itch.io right now, there's nothing on it yet. But yeah, you can find it right there. Don't worry, my Itch.io page is going to be in the description of this very video. And for those you have no absolute fucking clue about what I'm talking about, Fluo Green is a music mod for Holonyemi 1 and 2. Can we get please some fucking gameplay right now? Play gameplay footage! That because now we're gonna talk about more mods, and the other mod is just TF2 87. Well, no, it's called TF2.B, and it's a mod for SCP-87, of course, SCP-87-B. This one is already made, you can play it right now. I just wanted to tell you guys I've made it. because I made absolutely no YouTube video about that. Can we get some gameplay about TF2.P, please? Right the fuck now! Oh, and I guess before we can play it, I should probably explain what it is. It's basically SCP-87B mixed with TF2. It's a bit like SCP-87 Body. I don't remember my fucking titles, I'm sorry. Alright, let's play some fucking gameplay right the fuck now, baby.
Control point enabled. Get going. You are the last one alive. It's all up to you now.
Sandwich and me going to beat your ass.
Alright boys, well that was pretty spooky and funny. Alright, now time to talk about the mod. That's right, I'm talking about JSK Containment Breach, which is what I'm super passionate about and I can't wait to talk about right now. So, for those who don't know what JSK Containment Breach is, well there's an entire thing on SoundCloud called The Story of JSK Containment Breach, and it tells the entire story behind the mod and the making and everything and why I made it. But here's me explaining it for short. There's a YouTuber called JSKBin who played my SCP-87 body mod once, and I was like, holy shit, someone wants to care about my mod, and I made him an entire mod in SCP Containment Breach, which I started in 2018, and I'm still working on to this very day. I'm very passionate about this mod, as you can tell. The entire soundtrack is just this outro music remixed over and over again. I have released a demo for this very mod that you can download right now on itch.io.com, and he even played that demo on his channel, JSKBin, which I recommend to subscribe to him, because when I see him playing more games by me, who knows, he might even play with Funnel Planet one day, but I really doubt that with all the copyrighted music that's inside. But hey, what am I gonna do? The soundtrack is just so fucking cool, I can't just take that away. Anyways, I don't make money off the game anyway, so I don't really care that much. I mean, I don't make money out of everything I make, but I just love making stuff. For now, money is not a problem for me, for those things I'm working on. I'm gonna worry about that when I have to worry about that. So yeah, I'm very passionate about this mod. JSK played it. I recommend everybody to please give it a try. I modded literally everything in fucking SCP Containment Breach to sound effects in every single textures. The only things I probably left in here was a few sounds and the lights textures. That's pretty much what I left alive at this point. It even have an entire lore, surprisingly enough, this entire story. And guess what? I am inside this story, because I started off as a joke character, but I ended up making an entire story all around the mod. So, hey, look at that, I'm a character now. And yeah, I would recommend that you give it a try. So, with no further ado, let's play the trailer for GSK Containment Breach. And if you like GSK Containment Breach, there's not only a demo, there's an entire thing on SoundCloud about it, there's the soundtrack on SoundCloud, and I even made a GSK Containment Breach ASMR recently. How fucking great is that? Alright, let's play the goddamn trailer already. Hell yeah! Talk about a game real quick because I'm not even sure if it's gonna even happen, and it's of course a Backrooms game. It's about the Backrooms meme or Backrooms creepypasta, and the reason I'm not sure if it's gonna happen is because I'm lacking developers and I'm pushing my limits way too fucking much. So yeah, so there's that. If you're interested in helping me making that Backrooms game, so you're more than welcome to join my Discord and ask for a link to the official developer Discord. We're making a game where you just run around and punch monsters with a brick or stick or whatever the fuck you find in the backrooms, and you must, it's all randomly generated, you must escape the backrooms and stuff, so it's pretty great. Alright, it looks like that we're finally done talking about mods and games. It's time to talk about comics and albums. We'll start with the comics. We have three comics coming. We have a comic, Chiboy versus Thanos. We have we found a planet comic. Yes, that series goes a long way. Don't worry, you're not forced to read the comic if you want to follow the entire story. If you want to follow the entire story, just keep playing the games and watching the movies. And in order, please. And we're gonna have a comic coming in October called Disgusting. Hopefully I can make that comic happen. Where it's a comics about X-Boy, and it's just X-Boy slaughtering people, and it is what the title is. It's a pretty disgusting comic. So yeah. And it looks like it's time to talk about a final subject, which is albums. I'm gonna start with the lower boy and then the big boy. So let's start with an EP, which is mostly an album with a number of tracks in here. And there's a game called Dropsy. And it's a super wholesome game about a clown hugging people and helping people. And the soundtrack is fantastic. It's all by Chris Schlarb. But there's also an EP by Jay Tornin and some people with the support of it. And so Jay Tornin is an amazing developer. But and this EP, there's a lot of tracks I really, really like. I really like this EP, this Dropsy EP that you get with a special edition of the game. And my goal is to remix the entire fucking EP. And it sounds impossible. And yes, it does, but I'm working on remixing the entire fucking thing. So yay. And my second one, well, it's the big boy. And you know damn well what I'm about to talk about. G Remix 3. It is the final G Remix album. I know it's sad. G Remix has been on since 2015, 2016, I think. It's a very important album for me. It's like a big event. For those who missed G Remix 2, the thing is on SoundCloud, by the way. I should probably upload it on YouTube one day. I guess here's an E3 announcement. Fitting Blue and G Remix 2 will be all available on YouTube. But back to that. G Remix 3 is going to come out in 2020, hopefully. And it will be the final G Remix album. And I want to thank everyone who has been listening and supporting Jerry Mix. It's very important to me. That album means a lot, like a fucking lot to me. And if you want to listen to some tracks from Jerry Mix Street right now, you can go on my SoundCloud and you're gonna find some of them. Alright, now it's time to finally close that little E3. I really hope you enjoyed it. That video was really important to me because I talk about a lot of stuff that matters a lot to me. And if you want to follow those projects and know more about them, I highly recommend you to follow my Discord, because we literally have chats dedicated to each of those projects. Most of the games ones, but if you want to talk about the albums or the comics, feel free to use any chats, I guess, mostly the general chat. And if you want to get any update or any little sneak peek into those projects, you can follow me on Twitter, because I love tweeting about those fucking things. And yeah, that's pretty much it. There's also my Instagram, but apart from me just promoting some stuff, there's literally nothing about those projects really gonna find in here. Thank you a lot for listening. If you made it to the end of this video, thank you so much for caring about the things I make. You mean a lot to me. And I hope you have a great day. This video, like I said, was really important to me. I worked hard on it. It's very late. And I'm going to bed. This video should release when I turn 19, so happy birthday to me. Because it should also release on the 25th June, which is my birthday. And the best way to end this E3 is by doing my old outro, which I don't think there's any videos left of me doing it. But for those who've been here since the beginning, or if I have some videos left of that era, I'm gonna say it for the good old days, and that's how I'm gonna end it. All right. Have a good day, everyone. I love you.